Crystal Cave in Kutztown, Pennsylvania, and we are going to take you on a tour today of this fun roadside attraction. Crystal Cave was discovered in 1871 by two farmers who were interested in some farmland. They discovered a hole in the side of the hill. When they further investigated what they had found, they discovered that the crystals were not in fact diamonds, but was a whole cave system. Caves are an underground, hollowed out area of rock due to the limestone formations that we have in Pennsylvania. Water flows constantly underground and starts to dissolve the rock, creating a hollow space that the minerals can then rebuild up in some of these formations that you're going to see with us today. So you might have seen one of the signs as you came in that says, please don't damage. And you can kind of see areas here where it has been damaged during some of the earliest tours that came through here. But what you might not know is that touching is actually damage. This is an area where they used to encourage the tours to touch, and you can kind of see here where there is no growth in that area. That's because our hands and our fingers have oils on them naturally, and when you have tons of people coming through and all putting their hands on them, those oils build up and the minerals can't build up, so this is an area that has been damaged just by touching. So I'm here in the Crystal Ballroom, which is the largest room in Crystal Cave, and believe it or not, there have been weddings and dances and hoedowns here that have once held up to 200 people. This is the main room in Crystal Cave. Behind me you can see that drop wall that fell about 500,000 years ago and formed two of the separate rooms. We'll be in the top room a little bit later. There are two types of crystals that grow in here. There are calcite crystals and aragonite crystals of the Crystal Cave name fame. As I've already shown you, the growth of all of these formations is dependent on active and flowing water. Here we see the sandcastle formation, which is one of the only dead and dying formations in Crystal Cave because it no longer has an active water flow from the stalactite above it. So imagine you're on one of the first tours to come through here in the late 1800s. You're doing the tour by candlelight because that's all they had back then. And it has also taken you hours to get to this point because at that time there were no paved walkways. So you've spent hours traipsing through the slippery caves, and when all of a sudden, the lights go out. So we're here at Lookout Point in the cave. This is the point of the cave that is furthest from the entrance. We're at the wettest part of the cave, about 60 feet underground. This is where the stalactites are most actively growing. And as you can see, I've taken off my jacket because at this point it's a balmy 56 degrees, which is much better than the 30 degrees outside. So if you come here in the summer, it'll be a nice cooling off experience, which is actually what they used to do back before they had air conditioning. They'd come down here, cool off a little bit. And then in the winter time, it's actually a nice place to kind of warm up because it's a little bit warmer and less windy than the outside. This is called the Devil's Den. This is where the bats would hibernate over the winter. They would fly out of here at night to go feed on insects, and then they would fly back down here and hang out during the day. There are currently no bats here. We don't know where the colony went. There are some signs that it might come back in the future. We don't know why it left, but Crystal Cave once was home to a bat colony. So the dripping water you see here is essential to the formation of the cave. Water carries with it micro amounts of minerals that build up over time. The first thing that will form will be the stalactites that hang tight from the ceiling, and they'll drip their water down below to the stalagmites that stand mighty from the cave floor. This process takes a long time, and at this particular location, it grows at a rate of about 1 inch every 300 years. As you can see, this ice cream cone, or the spilled ice cream cone, is a lot larger than an inch. This formation is about 84,000 years old. If you're interested in seeing some of Earth's natural wonders, you can visit one of the 7 public cave systems in Pennsylvania, where you too can get an up-close look at the stalactites and stalagmite formations. Thank you so much for joining us today at Crystal Cave.